With me, Dan O'Donnell, joining me from Milwaukee. Everybody, tonight, a stunning story. This woman plans, pretends she's pregnant for months and months and months, even faking off her live-in boyfriend, her family, her friends. But then, hey, 9 months pass. She needs a baby, so she goes trolling, driving around, looking, stalking, praying on pregnant women. She finds one. She befriends a mom, a young mom, 23-year-old Maritza. She offers her a ride, and then the worst nightmares come true, slitting open mommy's tummy and taking the unborn baby boy out of her stomach as she lies there bleeding to death. So she fakes a pregnancy, Dan O'Donnell, and how does she do that?
Well, she basically was just telling people that she was pregnant. There was no physical evidence, obviously, that she was ever pregnant. She just lied for months at a time, telling people, oh, no, I'm pregnant. The baby's doing great. I can feel it kicking. And apparently nobody asked any follow-up questions about, hey,
okay,
can I feel the baby kick? Wait a minute.
Hold on, Dan. I hate to interrupt you again, but guys, you're seeing a picture, a photo of the suspect, the not pregnant. Back it up, Liz. I want to see that tummy. There she is, the one by the Christmas tree, where she's posing by the Christmas tree with a fake stomach, a pregnancy. Can I see the Christmas tree? I see the car. There. Oh, okay. So, Liz, let me get this straight. This is the defendant, right?
Mm-hmm.
Holy moly. So she's posing. She's not pregnant, people. This is part of her ruse. Then she finds a pregnant woman and slits her open with an X-Acto knife while she's lying there alive, takes the baby out. Unleash your lawyer, Satan Hughes Schwartzreich. All right, Eric. You took me down the garden path last time talking about the presumption of innocence, a jury trial, blah, blah, blah. She cut her own vagina, Eric, so she would be bleeding, okay? Response?
The bottom line is you and I cannot sit here, Nancy, and be judge, jury, and executioner. There is a court of law. This is
in medieval
times.
I'm asking you what the defense is. I'm not asking you to start a sermon. Good, let's hear it. Get down to it.
Nancy, lots of different defenses. First of all, whether or not Miranda was read and whether or not these statements are going to come in if there was a custodial situation in the hospital is a different situation. Who knows if she actually went through it, if she planned it? Was it the boyfriend? Was it someone else? She can argue anything in court, but the bottom line is
Holly
Hughes,
sits here at
right
least,
now, not
at
guilty.
Least after several minutes, he has spouted out a possible defense. Maybe she's going to blame the boyfriend, but after she's given these statements, I don't think that's going to work.
Well, and the problem with the statements, again, is they were taken by the lead investigator in this case, who himself, let's talk about credibility of witnesses, Nancy, because he's going to have to take the stand and say, well, she told me all this. This is a detective who has been investigated for committing three separate crimes himself, one of them a sexual assault.
Okay, hold on. So with that crime scene and those admissions, let me see, who should the jury believe? The detective and all the people at the hospital, or the woman who butchered a 9 months pregnant woman to steal her baby? That's a toughie.